So Chris Kelly again, catching up with Ben Shepard, who just got done presenting at our analyst event. Ben's from Lexmark, and you're their manager of their PLM Center of Excellence, right?
Yes, that's correct.
Okay. Yeah. It covered a number of different interesting things. I just want to ask you a few kind of deep dive questions on a few of the topics you touched on. Mm-hmm. One was you went through kind of the whole series of different things that Lexmark's done in its history around CAD. You guys have CAD history goes all the way back to 1980, but most recently, a couple of years ago, you guys migrated from Ideas to NX. Now, clearly, when you were making a decision about what you're going to move to off Ideas, you could have picked anything. Why'd you pick NX?
Right. We picked NX mainly because of data migration.
Okay.
So data migration, for us, we looked at other tools. We looked at what it would cost, how much time it would take if we were to change vendors.
Sure.
So certainly Siemens at the time provided a mechanism for us to migrate our data much easier. So I think per their statement that they don't leave customers behind, that's absolutely true because they had a tool and a process and a way for us to move our data easily.
Okay, great. Another thing you talked about that, you know, I just kind of had to smile a little bit was about the role of synchronous technology in that migration.
Yes.
When we launched synchronous technology, it's been over 3 years ago, one of the use cases that we imagined was exactly the one that you guys have lived through.
Right.
Can you talk a little bit about what the migration would have been like if synchronous technology weren't there?
Yeah, sure. So synchronous technology for us allowed us to use a boundary representation migration methodology. So we were able to just migrate BREPs of data instead of full history. And if we'd had to have done it without synchronous, double the expense, double the time.
Yeah, and a bunch of lost information.
Right.
You guys wouldn't have been able to build
exactly.
As much.
The quality of the data coming over would have been in question as well.
Okay, great. One other part that you focused on that, again, a lot of people talk about, but I saw one aspect of your presentation that was kind of unique in what I've seen, is the green, the environmental aspect.
Right.
You really tied directly what you guys are doing, not just from how you produce product, but the way that you produce it, your product development process and how much energy that's savings and you know, not only direct bottom line, but environmental impact.
Right.
What advice would you give to other IT managers, other engineering groups out there that are trying to really make a better connection, really metricize kind of their green objectives in terms of product development, product manufacturing?
Right, right. So sustainability for Lexmark is a corporate focus. Mm-hmm. So we spend a lot of time, we spend a lot of energy on it, no pun intended.
Yeah.
But essentially the advice I would give is to have a way to measure it.
Yep.
So certainly to know going in that you're going to be looking at sustainability and look at all of the choices you're going to make, software, hardware, and all the implications. And that's kind of what we did when we, you know, decided to measure, hey, how much energy are we going to save by removing workstations and using laptops?
Yeah, okay. That's kind of just a top-down comprehensive approach, look at every option and save where you can.
Yes,
great.
Absolutely.
Okay. Well, appreciate you again coming and speaking. It was an interesting presentation. I hope you enjoy the rest of the event, and we'll talk some more as the event goes on.
Okay, thanks. Chris.